Let us now study about the discharge current in RC circuits. This is the similar circuit we have discussed in the previous sections. There is a capacitor with initial charge plus Q minus Q on the plates connected with the resistance, and if the switch is closed at T equal to 0, a current flows in the circuit which discharges the charge on the plates of capacitor, and with time the charge on plates can be taken as plus small q and minus small q, and this charge can be written as we already calculated it as Q e to power minus T by RC. This is the charge on the capacitor plates as a function of time. And in this situation, the discharge current we can directly write as minus dQ by dt. And a negative sign we have taken because charge is decreasing with time. So the slope will be negative. So on differentiating this value, we'll get it as Q upon RC e to power minus T by RC. This is the discharge current in the circuit due to which the charge is decreasing on the plates of capacitor. Here we can also plot the variation curve of current with the time. As here we can see at T equals to 0, the value of current is Q by RC and exponentially it decreases down to 0 with an asymptotic behavior to the time axis. Now in this situation we can see at T equals to 0, in this situation the value of current is Q by C upon R. Here you can see it is Q by RC on substituting T equals to 0. So this can be considered in a way like on closing the switch. The potential difference across capacitor initially is Q by C. So the current flowing through the resistance is Q by C, because on closing the switch this potential difference is directly applied across the resistance. So we can say if there is a charged capacitor, then on closing the switch it behaves like a battery of EMF Q by C, due to which a current flows in the remaining circuit. And similarly at T tending to infinity, that is in a steady state, if we talk after a long time, the value of current, you can see it will decrease down to 0. As in a steady state, always in a capacitive branch, the current must be equal to 0. Now using these two results of charge and current in circuit as a function of time, we can calculate various parameters of the circuit. Like if we calculate the potential difference across capacitor as a function of time, this can be directly given as Q by C, where Q is the instantaneous charge on capacitor plates. So if it is known to us, we can directly write it Q by C e to power minus T by RC. Here the same potential difference will exist across the resistance, because here both are connected in parallel. The same potential difference will be maintained across resistance also. So we can write it VRT also. And if we calculate energy in capacitor as a function of time, then this energy as a function of time can be written as Q square by 2C, if Q is the instantaneous charge on capacitor plates, which we are already aware about. If we substitute the value of Q over here, you can see the value we are getting is Q square by, in this situation we are just substituting the value of Q over here, it is Q square by 2C e to power minus 2T by RC. You just be careful for the situation. This is the energy stored in capacitor as a function of time. Similarly, if we calculate the thermal power in resistance as a function of time, then this thermal power we can directly write as I square R. So the value of current we are already aware about. It is Q by RC e to power minus T by RC. If we substitute the value of current, we'll get the thermal power as a function of time. On a squaring it and placing here, it will be Q square by, this will be RC square e to power minus 2T by RC. This is the value of thermal power produced in the resistance as a function of time. Like this, in different type of situations, if you know the charge on capacitor and current in circuit as a function of time, you can calculate all major parameters of the circuit directly.